Greetings, Hotshot. My name is Jonathan Paul, and welcome back to my Riven Let's Play on the computer. Let's continue where we left off in the last video. No lights in this area, but that's okay. Oh my gosh, what is this? It's all the animals of Riven. I don't see any with a clear... This is like the end of Fifth Element, where they have to use the Fifth Element. Can I put it back? Because I am not certain I am pulling on the right one. If I pull on five and they're the wrong five, what happens? What's interesting is throughout our travels, I was able to associate one symbol, one of the eyeball symbols, with an animal, and that was the wark, and I think the wark is this one. The rest of these, though, I don't know. I don't even know if we've seen these other animals. Like, have we ever seen an alligator anywhere? We've seen a beetle. Yeah, this can't be random like this. I'm doing this wrong. There's like a huge section of the game that I have overlooked. Oh, they reset after six. Okay. There is no way I'm gonna guess this, and I definitely do not have enough information to do this puzzle right now. I feel like we're nearing the end of the game, but I also feel like somehow I walked past the middle. Does that make any sense? I think it does. So, we'll hit this lever and open our secret passageway out of this prison cell. I'm glad I came back up this way, though. Like, that was worth the effort. Now we're gonna go back over there and... we're gonna look for stuff. We're gonna look for whether I'm missing a big clue. I'm not sure what. But like most good puzzle games, sometimes you just have to walk around aimlessly for a while until something clicks. And in an effort to spare you of that endless boredom, I will skip over everything until I reach my next epiphany. Yes! Yes! I had a theory. Let's confirm if it's correct. The heating element is not on the submersible. The heating element is where it gets parked. And it actually stays on for a little bit after the mag... not the maglev, after the submersible leaves. So now we can walk past! But this is going to turn off any minute. I'm going to die. What does this do? Oh, I might have just turned it on permanently. Okay. Can I go through here? Or am I going to burn alive? No, I'm fine. I'm good. Okay. Yeah, I noticed that when I was traveling around that there was... it didn't turn off right away. Oh, yes! Another one of these. Alright, that's kind of scary. Let's not do that anymore. I get it right? That feels good to me. Do I need to write down these symbols? I don't know that it matters, but I'm gonna write them all down anyway. We got this one here, and it looks like it's sort of this, and this is under crater lake. All right. Is there anything else down here? Oh, I was hoping for more than this. I was hoping there was going to be some magic secret spot. But at least I figured out the puzzle, which was kind of staring me right in the face. It was just the thing was in the way. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Look at that. One of the animals. this is one of the animals. Okay. Okay, 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 okay. Screenshot. So this is, I don't know what it looks like. It looks like this. There's a round back and a beak with an eye. And he has 2 feet coming off the back and 1 hooked foot. There are 5 of these. All right, we have something to do now. We have to go to each of these little totems, these sacrificial totems. I forget what Gehn called them, but he mentioned in his journal that there were 5 of these things, and I think we know where they all are, and all are now, too. There's one that we can't turn, but that might be inconsequential. Now, where's the next one? Where are they all? They're all on Jungle Island, aren't they? I think they're all around here. There's another one up this way, by the water. There was another one in the tall grass. Okay, I think I know where we need to go. This is exciting. I'm very excited. We found a room where we needed to know 5 animal symbols, and now we just found our first animal symbol next to 1 of 5 sacrificial altar things. So this feels good. This feels like progress. I definitely need to use my mirror more often. That is that definitely missing out on some things here. All right, here we go. Ready? And now, no? Well, the other one presented itself very neatly. It was right where I wanted it to be. Oh, man. I know the other symbol will be around here somewhere. It will be. It'll be in the tree. It'll be nearby. I know it. I just know it. While we're here, though, let's click R and get the mirror off my screen, and we'll do another symbol. And this is a circle with, 11 to 9 o'clock shaded in, and then also 7 to 5 o'clock shaded in. And this is cliff, I, tree. But, I don't see a symbol. I don't see an animal.
Hello, viewers. Make sure to hit that like button if you think John's performance in this video earned your appreciation, just like John Voight's performance as me, Howard Cosell, in the 2001 film Ally earned him an Academy Award nomination. Okay, now back to the show.
I'm on a mission now. I'm laser focused. Just like the lasers that power the starry expanse. Eh, John? Very good, very good. Ooh. It'll light up orange when we're in the right spot. Okay. We're not in the right spot, not yet. It's down there. It's down there. It's over here. Let's rotate this thing first. Ooh, I kind of had it correct already, actually. Does it matter that these things are correctly oriented? They don't have a satisfying click like they ought to. In cave. All right. This is an animal. This is an animal symbol. Wait. It doesn't look like any animal that we've encountered. It doesn't look like a symbol of an animal. It looks like an absolute mess. All these stalactites are getting in the way. Can I knock them down? I want to knock the stalactites down. It's in the reflection! Ha ha! All right, perfect. That animal we know, because that animal looks like the wark. Oh my gosh, of course! You can't see the reflection if the water is... Oh, there, brilliant, brilliant. I kind of stumbled upon it. Oh, that's so brilliant. You can't see it unless the water is still, and the water isn't still until you do that. Incredible. That is such a cool puzzle. All right, so that looks like the same. That does look like a wark, right, with a big hump, a rounded back, and a fin here, and a fin on the front, and a face like this. All right, here are my notes if you want to keep up at home. Look, this is what I got so far. We got to go back upstairs. We got to go back to that other one, the one by the cliff. I'm positive we were right around the corner from it. But there's another one. There's another one by the... Let's do this one first. Let's go over here. There are five of these on the island. I am determined to figure out these puzzles. Now that I know what we're looking for, we're gonna find it. Whoa! Oh, that's cool. It's been trapped. Someone came by and stopped it. Oh, neat. Now we can walk over to it. The black hole is no longer. Now it's been locked in place here. That's kind of neat. Cool. Well, thank you, Atrus, or Gehn, for taking care of the black hole that would have surely ripped this world asunder. Right there. Same deal as before. I'm going to write down what I'm looking at. They are not complementary. If you've been wondering, three different symbols had their marks on the bottom. Clear cut trees. Okay. But now we can look. Oh, it's going to be this, isn't it? It's going to be all these stupid things. If I find the right spot. All right, so it's a long-necked animal with three legs. It's a long-necked animal with three legs. Okay. I'm going to draw the long neck and the head, and then it comes down, and then it has a little rumpus underbelly, and then it has one, two, three legs with some eyes. I don't know what that is or what it looks like, but that's a little freaky. All right, now let's go through the tall grass, because I know there's another one of these things around the around down this way. I'm going to just keep the mirror out the whole way, because who knows what we're going to run into down here, you know? Dunny. Bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum-ba-da-da-bum-ba-dum. I always do feel like we're going under the sea when we go through here. That's the steam pipe that powers the spinning dome. Huh. We can't do anything with that. I don't know if it matters, though. Oh, wait a minute. Is that something? This is something. There it is. There it is. You see it? Oh, look at that. When I'm close, this ring lights up. Like, it gets really bright. Like, that is pitch perfect. So we gotta go back to the one by the tree. Oh, you know what we have to do? We have to water the tree. If we water the tree and then look at... No, but I did that. I remember doing that. I remember watering, but we didn't look at it from the right spot. All those butterflies in the tree, if we look at them from the right spot after the tree is watered, I bet you it gives us what we want to know. I bet it does. See? This is something I didn't notice before. If you have your mirror out, when you fill this thing with water, the tree does get brighter. There is a noticeable change. I just wasn't using my mirror. So now, if I run down there quick enough before the water depletes, I should be able to see the animal. As I went, I did this. I filled it up. I went down there and I looked at the tree with the mirror, but I didn't look at it from the right perspective. And I didn't realize what we were looking for. In fact, if I didn't accidentally find that one under Crater Lake when I was just looking at the hole in the ceiling, I would have been completely lost. I had no idea we were supposed to look for those. It was not apparent to me. And then I kind of found that one by mistake and immediately realized what we have to do for the other ones. Bingo. Bingo bongo. Let's back up a bit. And that's your next symbol. Right there. Just looks like a little mushroom guy. A little mushroom guy. And he has a little thing. And then he has two little feetsies. Alright, cool. So I got my five dudes written down here. I got all five of them written down. Corresponding symbols. I'm not sure if the symbols are important. Like this, I don't know that this did anything. What was the point of that? Not sure. Did we ever have to do anything with the ball in Gehn's laboratory? Don't know. Do not know. What I do know is we're going to hop on the submersible and take it to the gallows across the pond, ride the trapeze up, get in the prison, go through the secret passageway, climb down the dark corridor, and then... Oh, I can't recall it from here. I got to go over that way. All right. And then we will put these five animal figures into those stones and see what happens. Is this the end of the game? I have no idea. There could be 20 hours of gameplay after this. I don't think there are. I want to say Riven for the average gamer is anywhere between, you know, 5 and 10 hours. I think if you're really good, you're really smart, you can probably speedrun it in like 2. There's a lot of stuff here that you can't like just blow past. You really kind of have to go through the motions, and there's a lot of motions. I would say, yeah, if you're really, really fast, 90 minutes, 2 hours, if you knew exactly what you were doing. But since most people don't, even me, the third timer, my third time through this game, and it still stumps me regularly, repeatedly. This is a good stumper. Yeah, I would say, yeah, 5 to 10 hours, probably. So I think we're nearing the end of this experience, but I'm not certain. Let's bring this all the way over to the bottom left, third base here. Hit the switch and head on over. I'll catch up with you in the room with the stones. For now, we know the five animals, so let's click on them. One of them is definitely not that. He didn't have a tail. He didn't have a tail. This guy was one of them. 100%. That was the one, the cliff by the tree. I'm gonna click that one. This was one of them. That was one by the tall grass deep in the jungle. I guess this is one of them. I don't remember him having a tail, but that's it. This is the other one. He had, yep. That was under the Crater Lake. And the only one we're missing now is the one that the butterflies made, the thing with the long neck. Long neck, this guy, right? Is this it? Doesn't look like he has three legs, but I never quite got a good look at it. I think that's it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's it. I'm pretty sure it's this one. That's five. That's five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? Right? Yeah, 1, 2, 3. Did I miss one? I did. That's 1, that's 2, that's 3, that's 4, that's 5. I didn't miss any. That's the one on Prison Island. Shoot. All right, I'll catch up with you in a minute. So we'll go downstairs, fiddle with the fiddler, and go back. We can't see Catherine, but Catherine told us the whatever we had to bring her, which I think was a book, was being held by the Moiety people. And we know the Moiety people are the one that gave us the mirror or left the mirror. And that's how we've been able to decipher all the clues, which makes a lot of sense. Now, for a while, I mistakenly thought the Moiety were just the people of Riven. No, the people of Riven are called Rivenese. And the Moiety are specifically the folks that Gehn talked about in his journal, who are the rebels, the ones sort of opposed to him. And that explains why the Moiety might have a book that saves our friend Catherine, and why they might be willing to help us by leaving these clues and things all over the place. That's my interpretation of it anyway. So we correctly span this spanner, spun the spunner, right? That looks good to me. So where am I looking? Where am I looking for clues? Into the open ocean? Do I have to be upstairs? Am I looking at the roof? Holy shoot. I noticed there was a couple of stakes in here, but now what does this do? Are there more of these? What is that, and what did that do? I gotta look for more clues. There's more of that around, maybe. Alright, just give a quick shout if you see anything that looks suspicious. Do you see any items poking around? Oh, wait. No, that's just sunlight. That's not a clue. It might be upstairs. What? Now, come on. That's... I mean, why would I tip it over? What's the point of that? Oh, I was really hoping this would be you walk right up and you collect your ticket and you go, but they gotta make it work for it, aren't they? Those clever sons of guns. I don't want to get too far. Every other hint for every one of these stations so far has been immediately adjacent to it. Oh, wait a minute. Okay. This means something. This means something. Okay. This is a viewer. And that's going to send light through that hole somehow. And it's going to bounce off something else. All right. I'm getting... This is a receptacle. Oh, wait. No, it's not. No, it's not. It's a telescope. That's the last symbol. So the last symbol is, I'll write it down. I don't really have a lot of space. I'm running out of space on my piece of paper here. It's a triangle with a little butt, it looks like, and then a line down the middle. All right, it's fine. It's like an arrowhead. I'm gonna be able to recognize it later. Now, what am I looking at here? Am I looking that way? Yeah, that's... Yeah, am I looking across? I think I'm looking across at Temple Island. Oh, this might actually be the beach where we first found the mirror, actually. If that's Temple Island and it's straight across from us... Yeah, I think that is. I think it's... Yes, right, so here's the tree. Here's the water tower, here's the maglev station. So the beach where we got the mirror is right here, and that's pretty much where that's pointed. Oh, that's cool. All right, figured out that little puzzle. Stumped me for a little bit, but not too long so as to be frustrating, but just enough time to be satisfying when you did solve it. That is the magical, magical sweet spot for all puzzle games, and Cyan certainly knows how to get it done. They do a great job. As I'm running back to the prison cell, quick tip for you, make a lot of saves at each location so you don't have to travel. You can just load an old save, because the only thing I'm taking with me is my information. You don't have to physically activate anything to get some of these symbols. You just have to know what they are. So I could have, if I had a save on Prison Island, I could have just loaded that, found the clue, and then reloaded and been done, but I didn't. I had to do it the hard way. So that sucks. Back behind the prison by the room with the animal symbols, and I found something on the wall here. Didn't realize that was a switch before. And what's really cool is this is a passageway back here. It's a shortcut. Look at that. Oh, it's a shortcut out, but not a shortcut in? Oh my god, what? That's frustrating. I was just there, let me back in. All right, finally, back here. After, for me, another 55 minutes of play, and all the ones that I left up are still up, which is great, which means we just have to press the last one we found and receive our reward. That was it. That was it. I did it correctly. I know I did. Oh, shoot. All right. Let's try it all again. This is definitely one of the symbols. This wark is definitely one of the symbols. This was the one in the cave near the beach. This was in the tall grass. Okay. This was on the tree by the cliff. This one was on Prison Island. And this frog-looking guy was where the butterflies were. That's six. That should do it. What am I doing wrong? So, sitting here looking at my screenshots and notes, it occurred to me that I have been neglecting a key part of this, which are these symbols. And they must represent a numbering system, right? We know that. Here we go. Here's the numbering system. Full screen. All right, so. One, two. Well, those aren't. They don't line up. One is the second one with the dot and the thing on the far right, which is the, this guy right here. So it's a sequence. So this is the first one we need to click on, this guy. So I think just using my notes, I can deconstruct which order we need to shoot these in. Unfortunately, something else I noticed in my notebook that I hadn't pieced together before is the one that Gehn has in his lab has to be the one from the tall grass area, because that one's missing one of these symbols, and he has it. Unfortunately, I don't have a screenshot of it with the magic mirror telling us which way is oriented up. So I have to go back to his lab and look at this and come all the way back here so I understand what order it's in. But I'm pretty sure that's it. I'm pretty sure we know the numbering system. We know that numbers are associated with each location. I wrote those down. Those are important. Now we know it's not just pressing the animals, it's pressing them in the right sequence. Although actually, we don't necessarily have to go back for this because, we could just figure everything else out, right? Or I can load a save. All right, I have a save here. I was just saying this is the way to do it. I need a clue, I don't need to bring it with me. So I can use a save load game and I can find out what I want without having to actually go back there, because it takes so much time. And it's so exciting to figure out a clue. And I'm thinking, you're like, wait a minute, there's a key part of this. So now we're right in Gehn's laboratory. This is perfect. So now I bet if I go over to this thing and I hit it with the mirror, exactly, okay. So the one that we're missing, the one for the tall grass, has to be the one that he had in his lab, and that has a symbol in the top left, like right here. Okay. All right, so now we have that symbol. That is great. Unfortunately, I did make another mistake, which is I did not take a picture of the Prison Island one. But I was recording my entire gameplay, so I just have to go back to that part of the tape and I'll be all set. Gonna age is somewhere. There you go. All right. And as you can see here from yesterday's recording, this is one way to do it. The one on Prison Island, which I forgot to take a picture of, was basically a triangle in the 6 o'clock position. So I'll close that MP4 from yesterday. I'll go back to my game. I'll load. This is the most ghetto way to, like, the game gives you a screenshot feature and I'm not using it, but I'm recording everything I'm doing. And the things that I didn't take screenshots of or photograph, like hidden ink, I can at least make a load and go back there. So we know all the symbols. Here they are. That's all of them. That's all the animals and all the symbols that go with them. Now we have to associate each with a sequence. So the first animal is this guy. This is a number one. After that, we need to find, I don't need to take a screenshot. I want to go to my notebook, my handy dandy notebook. Thank you, Steve from Blue's Clues, with that update. This is all theory, this is all guesswork in theory, but let's go with it. We have a running order. So, second is the funny looking thing from the clear cut trees. This, it looks like a frog. That's number two. Number three is the duck. Let's try that. Let's try to hit that one third. And then number four is the, what is this? A butterfly? An arrowhead? Number five is the jellyfish. And last but not least is the wark. All right, hold on to your butts. Oh, shoot. Really thought I had it. Let's switch two and four. Those are the ones I was taking big guesses on. So we will try again in a similar sequence. So this is one. And instead of, then we'll go arrowhead next. And then we'll go to the duck. And then we'll go to the frog looking guy. And then five is the jellyfish. And then six, last but not least, is the wark again. Trophy, anything? Yes! Trial and error, but we got there. That does it for this episode of Game Time. Thank you for watching. My name is John, and I hope to see you next time as we continue our Riven adventure.